high mountain stream somewhere in the woods of Middle Europe. To an aged oak near the edge of the stream is nailed a tattered placard which reads, Province of Zenda, Fishing Preserve. Trespassing forbidden by order of His Majesty the King. Just below the sign, stretched out full length on the grassy bank, is a young Englishman. His head is pillowed on a fishing creel, and his rod lies unheeded by his side. He's deep in sleep when two men in hunting costume come from the woods and stand over him. They gaze at him for a moment and then turn to each other in astonishment.
It's unbelievable. Look at him.
There is a resemblance, isn't there?
Resemblance. Look at the nose, the chin. Shave him and he'd be the king.
Yeah, he isn't the king, is he? I mean, I didn't have that much to drink last night.
Don't be a fool. The king's hunting over the ridge. Wake the man up.
Say, there. You. Wake up.
Oh, your pardon, gentlemen. Good morning.
Ask your name, please.
Well, since you've taken the first step in the acquaintance, gentlemen, suppose you give me a lead in the matter of names.
This is Colonel Zapt, and I'm Fritz von Tarlenheim. We are both in the service of His Majesty the King.
How do you do? I am Rudolf Rassendyll, traveling from England. Not so long ago in the service of Her Majesty the Queen.
Rassendyll? Rassendyll! By heaven, I knew there was some reason for it.
Fritz! Zapt! Where are you?
Here, Your Majesty.
Where?
Here, sir.
Confound you, I thought I'd lost you. Why didn't you... No, who's this?
He's by way of being a relative of yours, sir.
A relative?
It is something for which you cannot entirely blame me, Your Majesty.
Oh, then who's to blame?
If I may hazard a guess, Your Majesty, I would say that the blame might lie equally between your great-great-great-grandfather, Rudolf, and my great-great-great-grandmother, Amelia.
What?
Right by heaven, the man's a Rassendyll from England, sire.
That accounts for the king's countenance. If I was unduly surprised, it's too early in the day for a man to see double, eh, Fritz? But where are you staying, cousin? What are your plans?
I'm at the inn, sire, and I have no plans other than to fish.
You must come to my coronation tomorrow. I'd give 1,000 crowns for the sight of Brother Michael's face when he sees the pair of us. But of course you don't know my dear Brother Michael.
I'm afraid, sire, I haven't that honor.
We must arrange that he enjoy that honor, eh, Fritz? By the way, Rassendyll, what name did they give you?
The same as Your Majesty's.
Ha, ha, ha. There shows they weren't ashamed of us, Rudolf.
Thank you, sire.
You must leave your quarters at once and come to my hunting lodge. Tonight we'll dine you right royally.
I'll see to that, sire.
It's a night for celebration. Come on. Wine, Joseph. More wine.
Yes, Your Majesty, at once.
And now, Cousin Rudolf, I propose another toast.
Yeah, here.
A toast.
To our ancestor, that scandalous rogue, Rudolf II.
Yeah, here.
Let's see. Who'll be next?
Your brother Michael, perhaps?
Michael, why waste good wine? I'll tell you a secret about my brother Michael. He doesn't love me.
No?
No. Michael thinks the world's all wrong. He thinks he ought to be me, and I ought to be he. Let's forget about Michael. Let's think a toast to Cousin Flavia, soon to be my bride and queen.
Here, here.
It's a shame you can't meet the princess. At least I'm told it's a shame. I haven't seen her for years. She and I didn't get on very well then. Well, perhaps we shall now.
I should certainly hope so, sire, if you're going to marry her.
They say she's too good for me. Probably is. You know what they say about me, don't you? I drink too much.
Well, I imagine that you're well able to take care of yourself on that score, Your Majesty.
You're right, cousin. I can take care of myself. The devil take it, why is there no more wine? Joseph! Joseph!
Your Majesty. Your Majesty, please.
Perhaps we rubbed his hands.
Your Majesty. Your Majesty. Ah, it's no use, Fritz.
Hello. Yeah, that was quite an evening, wasn't it? Oh. What's the matter with the king?
Joseph found him on the floor this morning.
On the floor? Is he still asleep?
Very much so. You didn't drink any of this last bottle, did you?
Oh, not that I know of.
I think you'd know if you had.
Why? Was it drugged?
It was.
But how? Why? Who did it?
Who else but Michael?
Who else?
Michael? His brother?
Half-brother. Michael's mother wasn't exactly acceptable in court circles.
But the coronation?
There isn't going to be a coronation.
But this is fantastic. Impossible. What's in Michael's mind?
In Michael's mind? Only the throne and the Princess Flavia.
And has he a chance?
He has now. Michael is waiting in Strelsau now with Rupert of Hentzau. Half the army already on his side, and half the people, too.
And the coronation can't be postponed, huh?
If he's not crowned today, he'll never be crowned. He must be there for the ceremony.
He...
Yes. Yes, that's all that would be necessary. The ceremony.
So what's the matter? What are you staring at?
Englishman, I'm much older than you. As a man grows old, he begins to believe in fate. Fate sent you here. Fate sends you now to Strelsau to be crowned king.
What?
That sounds mad, doesn't it? But without your beard, I'd wager you could deceive your own brother.
You must be out of your mind.
It's a risk. Against the certainty.
My dear Colonel, I came here on a fishing trip. I like to fish. I am a simple Englishman. I couldn't begin to act like a king, even if I tried. Oh, no. No, I'm afraid not, gentlemen.
And Black Michael sits tonight on the throne, and the king lies in prison. Oh, his grave.
His grave?
Yes.
I see. Well, I can't. After all, it would only be for today, wouldn't it?
Tonight, you shall be safely across the border.
King, for a day. And what would it mean if I fail?
Your life. And mine. And Fritz's here.
And all I'd have to do is shave. Confound it, I'd become awfully fond of this beard.
Then you'll do it?
Yes, may heaven help the three of us.
I, Frederick Arthur Michael, Duke of Strelsau, hereby assume the regency of the kingdom and order and proclaim a state of martial law. Very good, Richard.
And now you sign, Your Highness.
Now, a last detail. Remember, this proclamation is to be released 20 minutes after Hensau brings you word that the coronation ceremonies have been cancelled.
Yes, Highness. We understand, Your Highness.
By that time, our regent should have the civilian disorders well underway. And now, Highness, may I offer congratulations?
And I...
A shade premature, perhaps, but... Thank you, gentlemen.
Oh, Michael.
Oh, come in, my dear.
Good morning, gentlemen.
Good morning.
And now, gentlemen, you may go to your respective posts. The hour grows near.
We go to serve our country. And our future son.
Michael, what did he mean, our future sovereign? Is there more to this mad plan of yours?
Well, as regent, the sovereign power will be mine. That's all he meant, Antoinette.
Oh, Michael, my darling. I know this has been your dream. I've tried to believe in it. Above all else, I want you to have everything.
Everything that is but power. Is that what you're trying to say?
But what will it bring but the end of all our happiness?
We shall be together, Antoinette. But where we belong, not outcasts.
We could have each other. Isn't that enough?
Darling, you must understand. Love is not enough. For any man.
Oh, Michael. Have I failed you then so badly? I gave up my friends, my family.
I know, and I love you for it.
I have no regrets. You've given me happiness such as few women know. I'd rather die than lose you.
Good morning. I'm sorry to interrupt, Your Majesty.
There may come a time, Hensau, when your services will no longer excuse your impertinence.
I was only training my tongue for the time when to call you Highness would be impertinent. Your Highness.
Your witticisms do not amuse us, Hensau. Why aren't you in your place at the cathedral?
Was there such a need, Your Highness, to hurry to the coronation of a king who won't be there to be crowned?
Do we want to make it obvious that we knew he wasn't coming? We must be there.
Oh, before I go, just one trifling matter. Detchard tells me that you've promised him promotion. Now, of course, rank and medals mean nothing to me. I can't raise money on them, Highness.
Well, it will take the revenues of half the kingdom to settle your debts, Hensau. We'll discuss your finances after our success. Take your place in the cathedral.
At once, Your Highness. Your dress looks lovely.
Thank you.
I called at your hotel this morning, but they told me you were out. Curiously enough, you were out, too. I'm glad you weren't lying to me. I don't like to have women lie to me. They don't usually do it, as a matter of fact. Usually I lie to them. You listening?
I thought I heard His Highness order you to the cathedral.
Ah, and now you too are trying to put me in my place. Ah, I like women who are arrogant. At first. It's always amusing to find that their arrogance is only a defense. But you don't need a defense with me. I'm on your side. I think Michael's treating you wretchedly. And what's he getting at in this marriage of state? An insipid, flaxen-haired doll.
Are you referring by any chance to the Princess Flavia?
Who else?
What possible reason could there be for such a marriage?
Well, how else can he get the crown?
But he doesn't want the crown. He wants only to be regent.
Oh, no. Really, mademoiselle? I should have thought you knew your Michael better.
You're mad. I don't believe it.
Oh, it's shameful of him to keep you in the dark like this. You want to hold him? Make him jealous. Ah, but you'll have to fall back on me for that. I'm the only man in the country who isn't afraid of Michael.
Get out.
Huh?
Get out, please.
Oh, of course.
But, Your Highness.
It's impossible,
Your Highness.
Recall the proclamation. Go at once to the cathedral. Cancel all plans for the public demonstration in my favor. Go on, hurry.
Yes, Your Highness.
Anything wrong, Your Highness?
Wrong? Oh, no, of course not, Hensau. Nothing at all, except that the king has just arrived in Strenzlau for the coronation.
Receive thou this symbol of temporal power, this scepter wielded these many generations by all our chosen sovereigns, sired of the ancient house of Elfberg.
Zapt, what do I do?
Take the scepter.
No,
kneel down.
Right.
Receive thou now the crown of the kingdom, and understand what a glory of sanctity and honor and bravery it signifies.
I, Rudolph, with justice and mercy to deal sovereignty, to guard with vigilance and honor the welfare of my peoples, from all enemies to defend them, and from the throne of my ancestors to bear faithful rule. All this do I swear.
God save the king.
God save the king.
Zapt, what do I do now?
Stand up. Stay where you are. The Princess Flavia must swear her allegiance.
Where is she?
There, coming toward the throne.
Oh, yes. But she's beautiful.
Careful, careful.
I, Flavia, do become thy vassal, swearing to serve thee in truth with life and limb until death findeth me. So help me God.
Do I kiss her?
Yes. Now to the church. To the carriage.
With the princess?
Yes.
Good.
This way.
I thought everything went off very well, didn't you? For a coronation.
What do you mean?
Well, I mean, of course, the coronation should go well if the king puts in an appearance properly dressed, knowing his lines.
And sober.
Yes, well, that's a nasty one. Don't you think you might overlook my past behavior and unbend a little? Don't the people want to see how well we get on together?
Why should we deceive them?
Oh. You know, I think the luckiest man in this world is the king of this country.
Really? You've always seemed to prefer Paris and the Riviera to this country.
Ah, but now I'm the crowned and anointed king. New leaf and all that. Among other failings, I've rather neglected you, haven't I?
2 picture postcards in 3 years.
Oh, and all this time, Flavia, may I call you Flavia?
Well, what a silly question.
Yes, that was pretty silly, wasn't it? But you see, I've been away for so long, and all this time you were changing into the loveliest girl in Europe.
I must have changed since you saw me. I've been thinking the same thing about you. You really looked and acted like a king today.
Oh, thank you.
Something I confess few of us expected of you.
Oh. Well, you see, when I looked at you, it seemed time for the king to settle down and try and live up to his future queen.
I think all this ceremony has gone to your head a little, cousin.
You're right, it has. I don't know whether I'm on my head or my heels. I only know this is the most wonderful day of my life. And this ride with you...
Well, aren't you overlooking something, cousin?
What?
Well, you'd better salute the crowd.
Oh, yes, of course. I'd forgotten I was king.
Listen, they're still cheering. They're with you heart and soul.
Well, it's you they're cheering. I felt like doing it myself when I saw you.
Why, we'd better go, you know. Your guests are waiting.
Oh, not just yet. Please. I want to have you to myself for a moment. All day I've been on parade. Cheered at, waved at, stared at. Not a chance to say...
Say what?
Well, it is enough to make any man lose his head a bit. I'm crowned king. I meet the loveliest, the most beautiful...
Oh, that isn't what you used to say. You used to call me that tow-headed little scarecrow.
Terrible. I hope you slapped me.
Yes, I did. And once I kicked you quite hard.
Good. I deserved it. But I've reformed.
Almost beyond recognition. You seem an entirely different person. I can't understand.
No, no, don't try. Just stand there and let me look at you. Flavia, I... Who's there? Oh, you. Well, Fritz.
His Highness Duke Michael is waiting to pay his respects, sire.
Well, let him wait.
What?
Furthermore, Fritz, your intrusion is decidedly uncalled for.
Oh, but, sire...
Yeah, that's enough, that's enough. Now, you may go.
I may go, yes. Yes, sire.
Oh, Rudolph, is it wise of you to make Michael angry?
I'm the one who was interrupted. Why should he be angry? Besides, I'm the king.
Well, he's probably furious.
Bad-tempered fellow. Why worry about him?
Oh, it's you I'm worried about.
In that case... I can afford to be generous. I'll see him tomorrow.
Rudolph, if you won't think of yourself, think of me. All my life, I've known what my future had to be, and I was resigned to it. Well, now, I needn't tell you how different it is.
Different?
I used to dread this day and the future, but now...
Flavia, I've been unfair. I didn't mean...
I only want you to realize how much your life means to your country.
Only my country?
Well, and to your friends.
Friends?
And to your cousin and loving servant, myself.
Flavia.
Good night.
Don't go.
But I'll see you tomorrow. Good night, Rudolph.
Tomorrow.
Tomorrow has come, and Rudolph Rassendyll, the impostor king, waits only for the return of the real king before leaving for England. But something has gone wrong. Colonel Zapt, who went to Zenda to bring back the king, found the lodge deserted, Joseph murdered, and the king gone. Now Zapt faces Rudolph in the palace at Strelsau.
Gone? What do you mean, gone?
The king's not there. They've taken him away.
But Michael's been in Strelsau all day. Still
that,
is.
That devil Hansau hasn't.
Well, then that settles it. They know everything by now.
Yes, they know everything. But they can't speak. They can't denounce us without denouncing themselves.
That still won't keep them from murdering the king.
Without you on the throne, they won't dare.
Me on the throne? No, it's too much to ask. Nobody could carry on this masquerade. I've tried to help you all I can, but I'm not a fool.
Yes, I suppose you're right. It's just that, you see, Rudolph is my king. I have a feeling about my king, about the crown. I feel about it the way another man would feel about his children or the woman he loved. He'd hate to leave her to her fate without making a fight.
What fate? Whose fate?
Can you ask that when the king is kidnapped, perhaps murdered?
Well, you know whom I mean.
Oh, the Princess Flavia. With the king dead, Michael as regent will declare her the queen, and after that, of course, he'll marry her.
She'd never do that. She couldn't.
Flavia is a princess of the royal house. She'd have no choice.
You can't let that happen to her.
Can you?
No.
Then you must hold the throne, Rudolph, until we find the king.
So, Rupert, you've been here in Strelsau. Why haven't you reported to me?
Oh, now would I disobey orders, Your Highness? I went to the lodge at Zenda, and I haven't been out of Zenda Forest since.
But the king hasn't been out of Strelsau since. And if you went to the lodge, what did you find there?
I found the king in the cellar, well and truly drugged.
still there? What happened next must have been Zapp's idea. Tollenheim couldn't have thought of it.
What was Zapp's idea?
Passing another man off as the king under your very nose, Highness.
What?
Odd, a man not knowing his own brother. But I assure you they might be twins.
Are you trying to tell me the man I saw crowned is an imposter?
Not your type of fiction, I see, Highness. Too incredible. But things like that do happen. You know, I once knew twin sisters that were... Oh, well, that's another story.
I'm beginning to understand. He hasn't been behaving at all like my brother.
Oh, naturally not, since he isn't.
But if this is true, why hasn't the king been heard from? Where is he?
He's in a woodcutter's cabin.
You've abducted him.
Well, it's an old medieval custom, abducting kings.
Rupert, only you could carry out such a coup. What have you done with him?
Well, first, Highness, there's one thing we haven't discussed. Now, why do people abduct kings? Just for fun, Highness? Isn't there usually the little matter of the king's ransom?
You can be the first man in this kingdom, after the king.
Oh, thanks. But how about a little something now on account?
More 10,000.
Oh, that's a poor price for a king. And a crown.
20. That's final.
Well, it's too cheap. But I do find him a bit of a nuisance, always whining about being chained up.
Did you hurt him?
Only slightly, but the cabin is very damp, Highness. I was afraid he might develop pneumonia.
And let the Englishman reign all his life? You realize, don't you, we couldn't expose him.
That hadn't occurred to me.
But if the Englishman dies first and is buried in the cathedral as the king... Yes. Yes, I think that's the solution, Ansel.
Oh, sire. There are moments in your presence when I feel myself an amateur.
Any news, Colonel?
No. It's perfectly clear we shall never find the king by watching Michael.
Gentlemen, the king is dressed for the ball.
Your Majesty.
By the way, Colonel, how is my kingdom?
Well, it seems from these secret police reports that the people are not entirely satisfied with the way you're handling things.
No? I thought I was doing fairly well for a novice.
So you are, lad. So you are. But listen to this. The king is much criticized for taking no steps about his marriage to the Princess Flavia.
I'm sorry to disappoint the people.
And the Princess Flavia. The princess's best friend told me very confidentially that the princess is becoming increasingly offended by your delay in proposing marriage.
That settles it. You must speak tonight.
I'll not propose tonight or any other night. I refuse to make a fool of the princess. Or myself. Flavia, you promised to go out on the terrace with me.
Is that a command, sir?
It's a command. Please. You're very cool this evening. Have I offended you?
You've said nothing to offend me, sir.
What you really mean is I've said nothing. Is that it?
Well, I'm sure you have excellent reason, sir.
Flavia, please try to believe me. I may be the sort of man who'd take advantage of any number of people, even a whole country, but I could never willingly do anything to hurt you.
I don't understand.
Then try to believe this without understanding. I love you.
Oh, is it true? Or is it only because you must?
I love you more than life, or truth, or honor.
Oh, Rudolph, I so wanted you to say that. Tell me, how is it that I love you now when I never even liked you before?
Never before?
You seem so different.
Perhaps I am different.
Yes. That's what's so wonderful. I wanted you to be different from the Rudolph I knew, the Rudolph I didn't love. And you are. And yet you aren't.
But if I were different, if I were not the king...
Why do you say that?
Could you love me if I were not the king?
Rudolph, does a woman who marries without love look on a man as I look on you?
Flavia, I am not.
Your Majesty! 1,000 pardons, sire. His Eminence, the Cardinal, is waiting to take his leave.
Of course.
Something wrong, Colonel Zapp?
Nothing, Your Highness. It's always my unpleasant task to be the reminder of duty.
Who is it?
Rudolph, I must see you.
Oh, Fritz. Come in.
Look at this. This letter, it's for you.
Can't it wait till morning?
But look at the name on the envelope.
Let's see. Deliver instantly, Rudolph Razendil, Esquire. Razendil? Can't be a tailor's bill from home.
What does it say?
If Mr. Razendil desires to know the whereabouts of the king, let him come tonight at 2 o'clock to the summer house behind the wall on the Boulevard Elfberg. He must be alone.
He must take you for a fool. A trick of Michael's, obviously.
If you hesitate, consult Captain von Thalenheim. Ask him what woman to do most. To prevent Michael from marrying the Princess Flavia. And therefore most to prevent his coming king. And ask if her name begins with A.
A. Antoinette de Maubach, Frenchwoman, mad in love with Michael, of course.
How far is the Boulevard Elfberg?
Are you going?
I am. At 2 o'clock tonight.
Duke's orders.
So I thought.
3 men are coming here to kill you.
Where's the king?
Before I tell you, your word. An English gentleman's word. No harm has come to Michael. Have I your word?
Yes, as much as I can give it, if you tell the truth.
They're moving the king tonight from a hut in the forest to Michael's castle near Zenda.
That's what I wanted to know.
Wait. If the castle is attacked, the king will be killed instantly and no trace of his body will be found.
Nice chap, Michael.
Do you want my help or don't you?
I want your help. But how can we rescue the king?
Leave that to me. He must have his friends near at hand, in his hunting lodge, on some pretext or other, or boar hunting, anything. I'll send you word when to strike. Now go, and quickly.
And you?
If Michael finds out what I've done, you and I shall not meet again.
Good luck. In everything.
And to you, with her. They've come. They're too soon.
Mr. Razendil! Mr. Razendil, pardon this untimely interruption. I only ask a word with you.
It's Rupert of Hensau. Don't trust him.
You don't answer to that name, sire. I have an offer for your majesty.
We can talk with the door between us, Count Rupert.
As you please. And true, while I offer peace terms. £50,000 in English notes and safe conduct to the frontier.
Ah, that seems handsome.
Come out, then. I have a good horse for you and the money ready.
Just a minute while I think that over. Stand there, out of the line of fire.
What are you going to do?
Sorry, but I'll have to use your tea table as a shield. Do you mind?
But how can you possibly...
As they start in the door, I'll start out.
Oh, they'll kill you.
Now stand back. Gentlemen, I accept your offer, relying on your honor. If you'll open the door...
It's locked.
Oh, but it isn't. Come in, gentlemen.
Get him! There he goes, get behind him!
Good night, gentlemen.
Understand you, Rudolph. Last night you made me feel that every hour away from me was wasted. But now you're going boar hunting. That's a different thing, I suppose.
My darling, did you dream that I was leaving you to go hunting?
Well, then you're not going...
Well, I'm not going hunting. That is, not just for boar.
Well, then what are you going... Oh, Rudolph, it's Michael.
Oh, it's nothing. It seems he's hatched a little plot at Zenda.
Against you? Oh, darling, you mustn't go.
Shall I tell them I can't go because we have an engagement to go riding?
But I don't understand.
And I can't explain just yet. But believe me when I say there are reasons why I must go.
I'm sorry. You see, I've never been in love before.
That's better.
You'll write to me.
I'll send you my heart every day.
And you won't let Michael hurt you?
No, sweetheart.
Or keep you from me?
No, sweetheart.
Nor anyone else?
No. Sweetheart. I must go, darling. You stay here. Your back turned. Don't look at me. If I see your eyes, I might forget to be a king.
You'll come back soon.
Shan't a man come back to the loveliest lady in all the wide world? 1,000 Michaels couldn't keep me from you. But if I shouldn't... No, don't. Don't turn. You will never, never forget me.
Never.
And you would be a brave queen and do your part.
My life would be empty. My heart dead.
But you would do your part. Goodbye, Flavia.
armed with the knowledge that the king is held prisoner in Michael's castle, Rudolph and the king's loyal followers have gone to the hunting lodge nearby to wait their chance to save him. Now, in the dead of night, Rupert of Hentzau has come to the lodge with a request to see Rudolph in private.
Come in, Hentzau. The audience is granted.
Your Majesty, I bring you your brother's humble greetings and his wish that you enjoy good boar hunting here in Zenda. And his respects, of course, to Colonel Zapt and Captain Frintz, your two principal boars.
I am surprised, Hentzau, and deeply hurt to hear that you willingly gave up your pistol at the door. Looks as though you didn't believe we trusted you.
I did it for my own protection, Your Majesty, not yours. In the best English plays, a gentleman never attacks an unarmed opponent.
Well, what price the crown today? The last offer from my brother was 50,000 pounds. Do I perhaps hear 52,000?
Well, the Duke offers you more than I would. I simply said, why not hang the play actor and save the money?
Indeed. And Michael?
He doubles the offer. 100,000 pounds. I told Michael you'd refuse. But the fact is, between ourselves, Michael does not understand a gentleman.
No, but we do, don't we?
Oh, Rasmussen, you're a man after my own heart. Frankly, you and I are the only two people worthwhile saving in this whole affair, now aren't we? Now, here is my plan for us.
Disregarding Michael?
Oh, Michael's such a bore. Now, listen. Attack the castle boldly.
Uh-huh. Go on.
Arrange the time with me.
I have such confidence in you, of course.
Black Michael will fall. The king, well, you don't want to find him. You won't. That's provided for. And your friends, well, if they fall too, then only you and I are left to know the truth. Understand? I, Rupert Hentzau, and you, King of the Realm.
I see. But aren't you being a little unfair to Michael?
Oh, perhaps a little, but I can't put up with his jealousy.
Jealousy?
Mm-hmm. You've seen it.
Oh, yes, yes, Antoinette. So the Duke gets in your way. Hmm?
Well, that's hardly a fair way of putting it, perhaps. I get in his way.
Surely she doesn't prefer the Duke.
Yes, the silly creature.
Then you're doing all this for love. How romantic.
Well, love and your Majesty's gratitude throughout your long and happy reign. And then, of course, you might make over to me Michael's castle and estate. Shall we shake hands on it?
Zap, Fritz, come in and listen to this.
I would also promise play actor to leave your golden-haired goddess alone until I wanted her.
Why, you...
Now, don't get excited, please. You see, I left only my gun outside. I still have this.
Touch me with that dagger and you'll be full of holes before you reach the road.
It's almost worth the chance. But I imagine we'll meet again, play actor. Perhaps under conditions more favorable to me.
Yes, I'm sure that's the only way we'll ever meet.
Of course. Good night.
Good night.
I wish we'd get some word. This waiting is intolerable. Why don't we attempt the rescue and be done with it, either Michael or ourselves?
It'd be a pleasure, Fritz. But what would it gain us? You think Michael would fall and let the king live?
Besides, what justification could I, the king, have for attacking my dear brother Michael?
Are we to do nothing, then?
We are to do nothing, stupid. And don't be in such haste to end your life, young man.
If you will forgive me, sir, your impatience seems on occasion to equal my own.
Oh, it's different with me. I've spent my life, and it's been a long one, in the service of the throne. I can do no more than die in its service. Now, or a few years later, what difference will it make?
It makes a great difference, Colonel. You've never seen England in the spring. Ah, there's a little stream I'd like to show you, too, where the trout...
Aye, lad. It'll be a pity if we never get the chance to go there. God grant that you at least may see your own country again.
I'm not sure it could ever be the same again.
I know, lad. I know. Come in.
A man is here who insists he has a personal message for His Majesty.
Have you searched him thoroughly?
Certainly, sir.
Send him in.
In here.
I'm Colonel Zapp. What is it you want?
I have a message for His Majesty from Madame Antoinette de Maubin.
De Maubin?
Well, what is it?
I am to lower the drawbridge at 2 hours past midnight.
But the king will be killed at the first alarm.
Yes, Majesty. She says before the bridge goes down, one of your men must swim the moat and go to the first room on the left of the corridor. The king is imprisoned there.
Yes.
That man alone must hold off the guards from murder until the others cross the bridge and get below.
Ah. Tell Madame we shall be on the shore at 2. Waiting for her signal. Then I will swim the moat. The others will wait until you lower the bridge. Now go.
I think I should swim the moat, Rudolph.
Right, lad. Can't afford losing both our kings.
One king you'll lose tonight. If anything should happen to the king and not to me, your game is up anyway. Oh, no, I swim the moat, Fritz, not you.
But if we lose you both, what will become of those of us who are left?
They will serve Queen Flavia. And I would to God I could be one of them.
Hafstan!
Here, Hensel.
This castle's gloomy as a vault. Where are you?
Here. The relief guard was 10 minutes early tonight, Hensel.
Why?
The Duke's as nervous as a kitten.
Must be expecting old Zap to bob up out of the moat in a diving helmet. Well, getting late. I'll have a last look at the doors and the drawbridge before I turn in. Good night.
Good night, Hensel.
Who's there? Who's there, I say? Sir Ronson. Lohengrin, was that you? All right, my friend. I see you. Come out of that shadow. I've got you covered. Come out.
Good evening.
Well, if it isn't the play actor, with his tin sword, too. Well, that won't do you much good now.
Pity. When did you give up knives for pistols, Hensel?
Oh, I carry both now. Extra precautions, you know.
They tell me you fancy yourself with a saber. Why not finish me off in more sporting fashion?
You might as well face it, Rasendal. I'm not a gentleman. And what a tragedy for both of us that you are one.
For both of us?
Yes, for if you weren't, it would suit me to keep you alive. Oh, how it would suit me. if I were only some king's twin. Ah, well, I'm sorry to have to kill you. I really am sorry.
I could be very grateful for my life just now. And you once mentioned something about Michael's castle and estate.
You think you can buy your life with a few old stones and 2 provinces of mulberry trees?
Half of my kingdom. For a cigarette.
Of course. You might as well. There are matches on the table.
Thanks. Ah! Don't try and pick up that gun, Hensel. Your sword will have to do this time.
Touché, Rasendal. I can't get used to fighting with furniture. Where did you learn it?
Oh, it all goes with the old school tie.
Well, if I must fight like a gentleman.
Don't let's be gentlemen.
Well, then, now for your last fencing lesson. En garde. Well counted. But your garden court is too high. By the way, what did you expect to gain by this visit?
The king's life, if possible.
Oh, not really. You know, your guard is much too high. I could finish you right now.
Not really.
Huh. Exit the play act.
Exit delayed. Sorry to disappoint you, old man.
Why don't you let me kill you quietly?
Why quietly?
You English are such a stubborn lot.
England expects it every man, you know.
Well, then, why don't you do it? I have to chase you all over the castle?
I'll take my fencing lesson in my own way.
Stand your ground and fight.
I'm just prolonging this as long as I can.
You're not afraid to die, Rascal. That's not British, you know.
It's just my nature. I'm keeping you away from the king until the drawbridge is down.
What?
Shall we rest now?
What did you say?
About what?
The drawbridge.
Oh, that. There he goes. Now, Hensel, stand my ground.
By you!
En garde! Don't wait too long, Hensel. Captain, his men should be here at any moment.
I'll just have time to finish you off.
There they are! What's the matter? Are we resting again?
Hi. I could have done it in another moment, but it's a little too warm for me here now. Au revoir, play actor!
Good night.
You all right? You're wounded.
Oh, it's nothing. The king?
He's safe. We've got him. And Black Michael, too.
That's good. I'm just a little tired. You don't mind if I just sleep, do you?
Rudolph! Fritz, quick! He's fainted!
You're sure you're feeling well enough to travel, Rudolph?
Oh, never better. How's the king?
He's weak. Still some fever. But we'll soon have him well and back in Strelsau.
That's good. Well, my work's done. I can go now. I'll see England again after all, Zap.
Wait. Before you leave, Her Highness wishes to see you.
Does she know everything?
Everything.
What did she say?
Nothing. She wants to see you.
Rudolph.
They've told you, Flavia?
Yes. Oh, you're hurt. They didn't tell me that.
My only hurt's the thought of the pain I must have caused you. Flavia, from the first moment I saw you in the cathedral, I've loved you with all my heart and soul. But forgive me.
It would have made no difference if I'd known. It was always you, never the king.
I meant to tell you. I tried to on the night of the ball.
I know. What are we to do now, Rudolph?
Oh, I'm going away tonight.
Oh, no, no, you can't.
I must, before people have seen me. Flavia, come with me.
Oh, if I only could. If only...
Why not? I love you.
And I love you. Oh, Rudolph, help me. Is love the only thing? If love were all, you would have left the king to die. Honor binds a woman too, Rudolph. And my honor lies in keeping faith with my country and my house. I don't know why God has let me love you, but I know I must stay.
God shows his purposes to such as you.
Goodbye, my beloved. Your heart will always be in my heart, and the touch of your lips on mine.
Your heart will always be in my heart, and the touch of your lips on mine. Goodbye, Flavia.